Kubernetes pods are ephemeral by design. The replicas can be scaled up and down, they come and go, they can move around to various nodes in the system. When we want to store persistent data, this becomes an issue. Storing data locally on a node is possible, but tying a pod to a node removes many of the benefits of running on Kubernetes. Fortunately, Kubernetes provides a persistent storage system that lets us keep the ephemeral nature of our pods, but still hang on to our precious data. We're going to set that up for our cluster in this video. To follow along with this video, you will need a running K3s cluster. You'll also need a working NFS server. I have a separate video linked in the description on how to set up a Raspberry Pi-based NFS server. Check that out first if you don't already have an NFS server. Links to all the files we create in this video are available in the description as well. Kubernetes has many storage options available. So how do we decide? Well, many of the options are provided by cloud services. Those are probably not what we're after when building an edge cluster. There are other options for using the node's file system, but those limit our pods to specific nodes or have other limitations that we don't want. After poking through the options, a classic NFS server seems like the best fit for our cluster. It's simple, reliable, easy to set up and configure, and it runs well on a Raspberry Pi. So that's what we'll use in this video. Let's talk about how Kubernetes specifies persistent storage. The configuration is split into two parts, persistent volumes, or PVs, and persistent volume claims, or PVCs. Kubernetes supports dynamic allocation of PVs. In other words, we can configure many PVs with specific access modes and capacities, and then make a claim with a PVC, and Kubernetes will select a PV that meets the criteria and bind those two together. Now, I actually set up my storage system this way originally, had a bunch of generically named PVs exported from my NFS server, and let Kubernetes pick for me when I made a claim. Over time, though, I migrated to more explicitly created PVs with names specific to what they are for ease of use, such as selected backups and whatnot. I find binding PVs and PVCs at creation time is more intuitive in a system where I'm in control of both the NFS server and the Kubernetes cluster. So that is the method we'll use in this video. Okay, enough talk. Let's build something. The first immediate need for persistent storage is our Docker registry we created a few videos ago. We've been using empty-dir, which will persist our Docker images so long as the registry always runs on the same node. Let's change that to real persistent storage. We'll start at the NFS server. We first need to log into the server. My server IP is 192.168.0.3, so I'll just SSH into that. Let's make a directory for our registry. Now we'll put an entry in etc exports for it. We have to add an extra option, no root squash, because many of the Docker images we use run as root in the container. Without this, those images will not be able to write to the file system. We could use this export as is, but that leaves this export as read-write to any host on the local network. We'd like to tighten that up a bit. We could specify each node IP here to limit these exports to just our K3s nodes. A more concise way is to use CIDR format to limit the access to a small subnet of our local network. So let's do that. Okay, if we use a CIDR of 192.168.0.48 with 29 mask bits, that will limit the access to this export to nodes with IPs of 192.168.0.49 through 192.168.0.54, which covers our node's IP range and gives us a little room for expansion. Okay, let's save that and quit. Now we tell NFS our exports have changed. That's all we need to do on the NFS side. For future directories, we can just make the directory, duplicate the export line we just entered, and change the path. That's it. Now let's create the PV and PVC for our registry. Let's create a file named registry-pv.yaml. First, the PV. We'll name the PV Docker Registry PV. Capacity is a required entry. It is used mostly for dynamic allocation, which we're not using. Also, NFS won't enforce the capacity limit, so it doesn't matter much what we put here. Let's put 1 gig. For access modes, we'll put read-write once because we want to be able to write and only one Docker node will be running. The other modes, if you're curious, are read-write mini and read-only mini. Now the NFS specific portion. We'll tell Kubernetes the full path of our export and of course the server IP. We'll set persistent volume reclaim policy to retain. The other option is delete. This tells Kubernetes what to do with the storage if we delete the PV. For NFS, I don't think either option actually does anything, but retaining our data is our desire, so we'll be explicit about that. We'll use claimref to tell Kubernetes that we only want it to sign this PV to a PVC specifically named Docker Registry PVC, which we'll create in a moment. Without this section, Kubernetes would give this PV to the first PVC that requested the same access mode and was under the capacity limit. Now let's create the PVC. We'll name it Docker Registry PVC. We'll specify a matching access mode, and we'll request 1 gig of capacity. Okay, save and quit. Let's apply the YAML. Now we can see both the PV and the PVC. Notice that they are bound to each other. Now we can use the PVC name as a volume in any pod configuration file. The next step is to switch out that empty dir volume with our newly created PVC. Let's edit registry.yaml we created in the Docker registry video. The volume is still named storage, so to Docker, nothing has changed. But underneath, instead of going to an empty directory on the host, the NFS mount will be mounted instead, and Docker will read and write there. Okay, save and quit that, and reapply our configuration. That's it. Now let's make sure it's working. If we secure shell into our NFS server and look at our registry directory, we'll see that it's empty. Let's push something to the registry. We'll use the bride API from the previous video. Let's get the source. Copy qemu. Build the image. And push it. Now back on the NFS server, we see stuff in our directory. Looks like it's working. Now our Docker images will be persisted for as long as we want, no matter which node the registry runs on. With storage covered, we've come to the end of this instructional series. Let's take a look back at what we built. We have a fully functional multi-node Kubernetes cluster. We can automatically obtain authentic TLS certificates for encryption. We can create custom application images from the convenience of our PC and deploy them to our own local Docker registry. We have the ability to persist data using our very own NFS server. Now we are armed with all the tools we need to deploy nearly anything on our cluster. No small feat. This is the end of the instructional series, but I still have a few videos I'd like to make about things I've deployed on my cluster. Also, my cluster is due an upgrade, so there may be a video about that if things have changed significantly. Finally, I'd love to hear about your cluster. Things you've deployed, modifications you made, ideas how I can make my cluster better, things like that. Please share in the comments. With that, I hope you've enjoyed this series. That's all for this video. Thanks for watching. If you like this video and would like to see more, please consider subscribing to my channel.